Glory template tutorial. We are going to go over the basics in this tutorial just to get you familiar with everything, and then we'll do other tutorials to show you how to work the website and how to get your site going. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to log in. You'll have your own password to log into yours. Once you log in, you're going to see the general settings that your site came with. And of course, you can move everything and delete or change or anything that you want. So it definitely doesn't have to be stuck to this. So let's kind of look around and get familiar with the site. These buttons up here are going to be your main buttons. Of course, you have your logout button once you're done, your commit changes, and your go to site. Once you make a change in your editor, you're going to want to make sure you always click the save button, if there is one, and commit changes. And once you do that, it's going to actually commit to any changes that you've made or done. And you can click go to site and it will open up a new window, your site, so you can look at the changes that you've made. Of course, once you're done with your site, it's always recommended that you log out so everything closes properly. So let's take a look at our Pages tab. And this is obviously where you can add and remove and change the order of pages as you need to. We're going to start with the Welcome tab. And you can, of course, change the name on this if you want it. If you don't want this, you can change that too, whichever you want. You can change the order, you can change the name, you can make it capital, lowercase, anything that you want, you can do that. The Welcome page here, we've made the home page. And there is optional wording, so if you go to your background image and you upload a lower opacity image, you can put in some text information and it will show up on your homepage. So if you want to put a greeting or information about your site or anything like that, you can do that there. The design possibilities are unlimited. So on each of these pages, you're going to have the option to do text, obviously, and have a background image, and you can make this background image anything that you want, any design that you want, as long as it's within the recommended size, which for these is 805 by 450. All right, and so we can just go and look through these. Of course, when you're working with your text, you can highlight everything, change it super quick down there. It's really self-explanatory, very easy. So let's go over to the General Settings tab. Each one of these elements, when you scroll over them, will put up a tooltip and tell you how you use what you've highlighted. This one on the logo is telling you, before you even click on it, when you scroll over it, the logo image displayed on the left portion of the screen, obviously, the logo needs to be exactly 185 wide by 450 tall. Your whole logo doesn't have to be this size. But if you put it on a white background or black background or pattern background or whatever, the exact image needs to be that size. The title is going to be what's showed at the top of your browser bar. Your footer is going to be what's at the bottom of your website. You can put any information in here you want. You can put links to your blog, to your client proofing, anything you want, you can put it in here. Your background color is the actual color of your website. Your stat counter code will be the code that you put in from site counter or stat counter, either one, whichever one you use, you can put in your HTML code there. You're going to want to put in your email address, and this will make the contact form work, so make sure you change that. Your background image is going to be the overall image of the entire background. We recommend that you put it at no larger than 1800 by 900 high. Your gallery background image is going to be the image that is behind your images in your galleries. And we'll show that to you. We'll show that to you in another tutorial. The menu color is your navigation color of your font, of your menu bar at the bottom of your site. You can change this to any color that you want. You can even put in a custom code or anything that you want to put in there. Your menu font. You can choose any of these web-ready fonts. Your menu size is going to be your navigation bar size. The gallery thumb border is the color of the border that's around the images in the gallery. The hover color is the color of your links when somebody puts their mouse over them. And the contact us form, thank you, is the information that you want to be displayed when somebody fills out your contact form. It will take them to this page. In this case, thanks for your email, we'll return shortly. Then you'll have the option to either click to go back or it automatically redirects you after so many seconds. Of course, if you need more space to see these, you can always move this over and adjust that as you need to. Let's go into the Galleries tab. This is where you're going to upload your images and create your galleries. And your system settings, you do not want to change any information in here except your password. If you want to change your password, you can. If for whatever reason you mismatch the passwords, do not click commit changes because I will have to reinstall your site. So make sure if it says that your passwords do not match, don't do anything. Just click log out, sign in with your password, and then try and reset it again if they don't match. And that's it. It's a great site. It's easy to navigate. It's easy to customize. And of course, if you have any questions, you can always contact us. Thanks so much.